Look at this picture. See those kids' hands? Well, the Collier County waterkeeper says they got those rashes after digging in the sand. This was on Tiger Tail Beach in Marco Island. Health officials keep telling us, don't go to the beach right now. Even if it looks nice out there, there's a lot of dangerous stuff in the water and the sand.
NBC2's Alex Howard is local tonight on Marco Island, talking to people who got sick after going to the beach.
I don't think the water is very safe right now.
On the Friday after Thanksgiving, the only people we saw on Tiger Tail Beach were there for just a stroll in the sand.
We're not going to walk in the water right now. Normally, we would just walk across to get to the beach through the pond here, the lagoon, but no, it's just the hit hasn't gotten the oil clear yet with the red tide coming down.
But stepping on the sand can be just as dangerous as the water because bacteria clings to it and then you. The Collier County waterkeeper shared a photo of rashes on children's hands. They visited Tiger Tail Beach. Just a few weeks ago, we heard from another woman who got a severe rash from the same place.
It also started burning. It was like on fire.
Jessica Kirschenbaum went shelling, but ended up in the emergency room for her skin infection.
Bacterial contamination in beach sand is a known issue.
Casey Schulberg from the Collier County Waterkeeper wants the county to set up signs warning people.
So we know that pathogens exist in these waterways and on the beaches, and it's no wonder since we just had, you know, a virtual tidal wave come on shore, and when it receded, it dragged all kinds of nutrients and pollution and sewage with it.
Reminding them that even here in Marco Island, the beach and water aren't quite safe.
With a skin rash, it's disturbing. It's a little unsettling, but it won't kill you. There's other bacteria that are other pathogens that are even more dangerous.
We're local on Marco Island. Alex Howard, NBC2.